Welcome back to Elden Ring. Let's explore the mountaintop of the giants. Rhymed Roa. That's new. Be wary of strong foe. Okay, they dodge a lot. Let's do... No, Ambusher didn't work too well. Well, I don't know. Let's try it again. Yeah, I think I prefer Night Gauntlet. There's something in there. No. I mean, cozy place, I guess. Oh, that's just the standard enemy, isn't it? They keep trying to dodge into the corner. Doubt the other one's gonna be that easy, though. Actually, it kind of is. Burning a lot of FP doing this, though. XP for each one. I see a cellar. Spells, more ice storm. No enemy ahead. Smithing stone miner's bell bearing. I think that'll get me tier 5 and 6 stones that I can buy from the store unlimitedly. I think that's it for these ruins. Do you want to take a peek around the corner up here, though? Alright, then that's just the lift of rolled. Oh, there it is. I was wondering if they would attack me. These ones, thankfully, don't have anything on their claws or anything like that. They just don't like me. Try fire, and didn't expect bird, and then behold, bird. Does it appear from up there? Don't see it yet. Can go that way. What's this way? Oh. Like a cave. Hmm. That feels like the critical path. This is maybe something extra? Bird up. I don't see any birds. This goes nowhere at all. I think if I went through the cave the normal way, they would all ambush me, but this time I have to drop them. These like the fire monks, or whatever they're called. I think so. Briars of Punishment. Probably an incantation. Wait, no, it's not. No, it's not, but it does take faith. Does someone need a laser beam? Goodbye. That was a good call. They look like probably a big enemy, and yeah, they seem to have had about 5,000 hit points. Worth it. Didn't drop anything special though. Looked like they had a cool whip. Underground tomb ahead. Wait, where does that cave flee to that I thought was up there? That doesn't, like, I thought it would lead there. Wait, is it not actually a cave? Oh, it's not. Just kind of look like one from a distance. Giant's Mountaintop Catacombs. The beast eye quivers. Why is it always dog? Three of them.
Hmm.
I knew they only had a couple hit points left, so I did a staff attack, which did 11 damage, and that was all I needed. Secret pathways. Nope. Ah. It did say down required ahead. Thought there might be something up with that. But there's still all this. Let's go down first. They have like a frozen tail. Oh, damn. God, their hits really hurt. This is a super strong one. Might be time to get out the laser beam. Oh, I don't think it's gonna work. It's moving. Worked enough. Took out a good chunk of their health. Dog. Try ranged battle. Looks like that should be breathing fire or snow. Maybe it says watch out for snow. Be wary of snow. It's not breathing out any. Ah, okay, here it is. Yeah, everything here does frost damage. Ah! They were right. There is a shortcut ahead. Well, actually, no, it's not really a shortcut, is it? But there's an illusory wall ahead. I don't have my potion, but I can still do a decent laser beam. Oh, fuck. That didn't work out too well. Fire monk ashes. Spirit of a stout monk who monitored the giant's flame, versed in fire incantations and himself steeled against fire. Though he was charged with keeping watch over the flame, after many years of solemn duty, he has succumbed to its allure. Now let's explore the normal pathway. Boys. Beware of ambush. Try stealth. I'm pretty sure they know I'm here. Whoa. Try ranged battle and then fire. Oh, all these pots are gonna try to explode on me, aren't they? Yup. Jesus. accidentally switched to my torch. I meant to have my shield out. Friend? It's not a friend. Ooh, these will give me health with each kill. Mysterious hole with no ladder to get back up. Once again, that area down there looks like a place I've already been, but it might not be, actually. I mean, it can't be, because I don't think there's any other way to go, and I need a lever. Oh, if you wait too long, they just don't explode. Okay, there's a way up, and there's an elevator. Have I not been here before? Non-elevator route first. No, we have been. Wait. No? This looks exactly the same, but like some of these pots are alive and I thought I killed them all. Let's assume this is brand new. Oh, Jesus. Dungeons always confuse me when everything looks the same. Oh wait, no, you don't have an explosive. I can ignore you. Isn't that the room where I just got one of the, like, ghost glove warts? Oh, hello. That's new. What'd they just do? Sorry, pot, but I need to be able to look around me. Could be something down there. Oh, there's the lever, finally. Here we go. Yeah, I don't have a lot of resources, though, but, let's give it a try. Oh no, is this gonna be- yeah. Oh, there's no way I can do this with my resources. Well, actually, okay, there is a way. I do have enough to be able to get, like, the bursts of this thing don't cost that much. Yeah, we might be okay. Whew! Just enough. Glovewort Picker's Bell Bearing 2. Ooh, and a chest. Ah, death root, right, the eye quivered. Let's give Garonk the death root. Beastclaw Great Hammer. Takes 20 strength, 10 dex, and 18 faith. Does holy damage. Great Hammer with a striking end model to resemble 5 beastly claws. The black nails protruding from golden fur are said to represent Sarosh, Lord of Beasts, who went on to become King Godfrey's regent. Let's level up my mind and get more FP. Let's also take a look at that new spell. Oh, I actually don't have any free slots. Well, let's see how many it takes. Oh no, I have to select a slot before I can select a spell. Well, Ambush Shard has not been playing out too well for me, so toss that. Some more Ice Storm. Ice sorcery of the town of Zamor. Strike the ground with the staff to create a freezing tornado. Charging enhances potency. Cloaked in icy tempests, the knights of Zamor have challenged the fire giants since ancient times. Takes 36 int. 22 FP, relatively expensive. Not super expensive, though. And just one slot. That's uncharged. Let's charge it. See if the diameter goes up, maybe. Oh, yeah. I think that did affect a wider area. So I'm guessing it's a mixture of damage and frost. I bet it'd be particularly good against these fire people. Oh, it does damage over time. Try just tapping it. How good is that, though? It's doing like 700 damage over time and taking 20 FP, which is more FP than just this, and this does only a little bit less damage. Let's try it on this harder one, because it can soak more damage. Oh my god. Okay. Oh, they have a nasty whip. Not really the kind of person you want to get close to. God. Yeah, glad I laser beamed them the first time. We got their armor. That was extremely heavy. By far the heaviest I have, actually. Black iron armor adorned with a red cloth. Okay, yeah, I thought it was more like a cape, but that's just over the actual metal part. Attire of the fire prelates, commanders of the fire monks. The weighty frames of the prelates symbolize the onus of their grave vows as guardians of the flame. Etch the sight upon thine breast of my thunderous gravity. I don't think that's very me. Oh. We're walking across this. And as someone said, archer ahead. be wary of sniper. Where? I'm gonna have my shield up. Like, where would they even shoot me from? Oh, it's a giant archer. Okay, they're shooting. Whoa, my God. That very suddenly almost pushed me off the edge. There's definitely things to explore down there. Don't give up, skeleton. Oh, that one. Ooh. Fire up there. Maybe a merchant. I think I'll have to get to that in the future.
Do you hear me? It is I, Latena. We're almost there. Castle Sol lies just off to the north. Where the other medallion is housed. It will grant passage to the land of the Halig Tree.
It's been so long since we've heard from them. This must be the castle they were talking about. Let's go over this way. Right, there's a zoom in. Small ruins over there. Oh, look at that. I hope we get to run up the chain. First. Well, I guess I want to save the castle pretty much for last. Let's go. Well, actually, this freezing lake side of grace is pointing down this way, so maybe you have to go this way to then get to the castle. Well, regardless, let's go this way anyway. Ash of War Seppuku. What good would that be? Like, really, what good would that be? What is the description for it? Oh, it does, well, it does give it the blood affinity, but I mean, these do as well. Forbidden technique used by swordsmen from the land of reeds. Plunge the blade into your stomach to stain it with blood. Increases attack power and improves ability to inflict blood loss. Usable on swords as well as polearms capable of thrusting. Small and colossal weapons accepted. Hmm. Well, it doesn't say that it hurts you, but I'm assuming it hurts you. That snow is not rendering right. Like that blizzard. Oh. Bird, up. Fly, bird, fly. Are you a dragon? Of course. Just seeing it's going to be difficult. What are the likelihoods of me getting a laser beam off? Bait out an attack. I'm gonna try to bait out some sort of attack that preoccupies it. Not a foot stomp, like some magic casting thing. Oh yeah, this is good. How dare you! Worth it. I mean, I died, so not really. I'm gonna try the laser beam one more time. Dang. Okay, actually, no. I want to try to give it Scarlet Rot. Well, it seems to have angered the jellyfish. And it still doesn't have Scarlet Rot. Oh, I think it has it now. Yeah, it does. I don't know how long it lasts for. So I don't know if I should just run away and let it slowly die. Okay, it's really far away, so... Woo! So that's not gonna reach too well, but great bow would be good. Color rot still working? Nice. Oh, come on. Okay, well, it died anyway, so I think I get the kill. Yeah, that scarlet rot worked really well. Seems like it lasted for the entire... Yeah, there we go. Entire rest of the fight, so... I don't know how long that was. Lasted at least a minute? I wonder if the dragon not showing up is gonna make it so I can see better out here. That might have been why everything got extra frosty. Yeah. Yeah, now we don't have that super heavy storm. Oh, those are not dead. Frosty crustaceans. Do you drop anything special? Just a strip of white flesh. The First Church of Marika.
Of Queen Marika linger here as well. Shall I share them with you? In Marika's own words, hark, brave warriors. Hark, my Lord Godfrey. We commend your deeds. Guidance hath delivered ye through each ordeal to the place ye stand. Put the giants to the sword and confine the flame atop the mount. Let a new epoch begin. An epoch glistening with life. Brandish the Elden Ring for the age of the Erd Tree. We're almost there. The flame of ruin lies just ahead. I'm glad it was you I traveled with. I must tender my thanks to Torrent, too. Thank you, Torrent. Please continue to lend your aid. Till the end.
We have a sacred tear. Might have 4 or 5 seeds. 5 seeds. Not yet. Oh, I can level up as well. Let's go with mind once again. This place is pretty peaceful, even if things do try to kill you occasionally. Ooh, Spirit Spring. I feel like there could very easily be a cave in these. Oh, we're in an area that has no map fragment. We should get it. Is it up here? It's across the bridge, I think that is. Actually, I think that's a chain. But I think it acts like a bridge, probably. Lord Contender's Everjail. Weak foe. Why is it always a weak foe? It has a lightning. Try two-handing. I'm gonna try laser beaming. Okay, well, I got him down half. I think we got a night comet. Ooh, Vike's dragon bolt and a whole set of their armor, which is fingerprint stuff. I think we got an incantation. Yep, dragon bolt. 23 faith. But yeah, that armor. Iron helm singed and blistered by fingers, worn by Vike, knight of the Round Table Hold. No other tarnished was closer to the throne of the Elden Lord than Vike, but without announcement, Vike traveled far below the capital and was scorched by the flame of frenzy. Did he make his choice for his maiden, or did some other force lure him with suggestion? It is really cool the way it's melted. Yeah, quite raggedy. No, those do not work. Oh, what did I even have on before? Vitamin these? I'm going to assume so. Fingerprint greaves are quite a bit lighter and worse at everything. I don't need something lighter, so I probably wouldn't go with that. Let's just see. Oh, the part we can see just looks pretty basic. Nothing much there. Where exactly is the church? There. Well, let's just head towards the map fragment. Yeah. Sorry, puppy. Bonfire surprisingly close to the church one. Okay, thankfully this one has a shorter range weapon. Wow, they're like unfreezable. So a lot of these bodies. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, there's a lot of these bodies just here covered in spiky thorns. You can see from what they're wearing, it's red robes just like the fire monks wear. So I think it's just dead fire monks. Yeah, they have the same vines around their head. And they're all down like they're praying, like they prayed to their death. Or prayed till their death, rather. Wait, this isn't the castle, is it? Like, from here, they said it's to the north, I think, so I'm pretty sure they're talking about this one. But this is obviously some sort of a castle. But no, map fragment first. Ooh, I did freeze that one, actually. Prelate's Charge, Ash of War. Oh, wow, this actually leads somewhere. Oh. Too close to the castle. Kicked me off the horse.
Ah.
Yeah, I think I can get that item I saw there just from inside of the castle. Or around the entrance, I think. Yeah, this is a great chain. And it is a bridge at the same time. Oh, I wish it swayed. What is that? What is that? I think that might be one of the Divine Towers. Doesn't even have a bridge going to it, because you have to get teleported. Well, I think this is a good place to end the episode. I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, we're going to explore more of the mountaintop of the giants.